Myself, Mr. Vijay Gole. My registration number is MTE009. My school name is Dr. Datta Saman, Madhyamik Vidyalaya, Kanjurmarg, West Mumbai, 17. District, Mumbai North. Topic, description. Here, today I am going to introduce inscribed angle and verification of inscribed angle theorem. This video-based PowerPoint presentation is guided by Professor Inder K. Rana, IIT Bombay, also by Professor Santosh J. Garpure, IIT Bombay. My presentation will be mainly based on three categories. Number one, observe and explore. Number two, define and prove. And finally, apply and evaluate. So let us go to the first part, that is observe and explore. Now students, you have to watch the image which is displayed on the screen. Now students, you know that when we go to movies, now we want to be close to the movie screen, but we do not want to have to move our eyes too much to see the edges of the picture. Now here, look at the screen, look at the picture carefully. Here we can see that AB is nothing but it's a movie screen. Okay, and A and B, they are the end points of the screen. Now imagine that you are at point E. Therefore angle AEB is your viewing angle. Viewing angle is nothing but what? Where, from where you can view the movie screen without moving too much of your eyes. So students, look at this image carefully and name different viewing angles through which you can see the edges of the pictures without moving your eyes. So the answer is yes, angle ACB, angle ADB. Very good, right? Now let us observe few more images. Take your time, okay? Two more images are there. Observe them carefully. Now students, let us define and prove what we have seen. So today we have seen the viewing angle. Not only that, you also viewed few of the images and I asked you to observe the angles. So the angle was inscribed angle. Now what is that angle? That is the question in your mind. So let us define that angle. The angle name is inscribed angle. You can see one of the vertex of inscribed angle is on the circle and whose sides contain the chords of the circle. Now here you can see AB and AC, they are the two chords, okay, which forms angle BAC. Now angle BAC is nothing but what? Inscribed angle. Now let us understand the next concept, that is intercepted arc. Let us define it. The arc that lies in the interior part of the inscribed angle and has its endpoints on the angle is known as intercepted arc. In the diagram, you can see here arc BXC has got its endpoint B and C on the angle BAC, which is nothing but intercepted arc. Next. Now, let us understand the property which we are going to verify further, that the measure of inscribed angle is half of the measure of the arc intercepted by it. Now measure angle BAC is nothing but what? It is half of intercepted arc, that is BXC. So we are going to prove this particular inscribed angle theorem with the help of two activities. Let us understand the first activity, which is GeoGebra. Now here, this is GeoGebra window. Now students, you know this is a toolbar. Okay, now here first we have to select the circle wala tool, that is circle with center to the point. Let me select this tool and now we have to click on graphic view. Now you can see here this circle is with variable radius. Okay, we can draw a circle with the radius which we want. The circle can be expand further. So let me click over here. This is my circle. Now on this circle we have to plot three more points. Okay, so for that you need to choose point option, that is point on object. So here you can plot first point, then second point, and then third point, say point C, D, E respectively. Now with the help of segment tool, okay, I can join all this segment, say segment DC, segment DE, then segment DA, and finally segment AE like this. Now what we are going to do further is we are going to measure this inscribed angle and this central angle. We all know DAE is the central angle. So let us do this with the help of angle tool. Okay, you have to select the angle tool. Let me click on the points, that is D, C and E in clockwise direction. So my angle is 63.35 degree. Now same thing we are going to do with central angle, that is D, A and E. Now you can see here this inscribed angle, okay, is half of the central angle. By this you can always verify that central angle is two times the inscribed angle, that is inscribed angle is one of the central angle. But the property is nothing but what is our property? That inscribed angle is half of the intercepted arc. Now we all know that central angle is equal to the arc intercepted by inscribed angle. So these two values are same, therefore one can verify that inscribed angle is half of intercepted arc. So have you understood, students? So now let us minimize this and let us go to the next PPT. Let us go to the next activity. Now this you have to do on your own. So for that you have to, here I am going to provide you drawing paper, colored craft paper, compass and scissor. With the help of this material we have to do this activity. Now students, take paper in your hand and first you have to draw a circle of any suitable radius on drawing paper. Have you done it? Good. Now next you have to draw central angle AOB and inscribed angle APB inside the circle. After doing this you have to measure angle APB with the help of compass, with the help of protractor. Okay, now cut angle APB two times from the colored craft paper. Put these two pieces on angle AOB. You can see here angle AOB, these two pieces we have fixed. Now what is our observation? The observation is two pieces hides the angle AOB. What is the inference from this? The inference is angle AOB is two times angle APB. So this activity also will help you to understand that inscribed angle is one half the intercepted arc. Now the next thing is apply and evaluate. Now in apply and evaluate, look at the figure carefully. Now here we all know boats use measure of angles and arc lengths for sailing in treacherous water. If a captain uses his navigation charts to track the angle formed by two lighthouses in between a boat, he can stay out of the dangerous area. So how will you do this? Now with the help of compass and your partner determine 3 to 5 things about the diagram and be prepared to share your findings. Next, there is one question. Let me read this question for you. Okay, it is based on inscribed angle theorem. In triangle ABC is inscribed in a circle with center O. Segment AX is a diameter of circle and with radius r. Segment AD is perpendicular to segment BC. Now this is the given thing. Now what we have to prove? We have to prove that triangle ABX is similar to triangle ADC, and also area of triangle ABC is equal to ABC divided by 4 times R. Now look at the diagram. Okay, the sides are AB, BC and AC. Side AB is C, side AC is B, side BC is A. Now we have to join BX. Okay, now here is the solution for you. Major angle ADC is 90 degree, as you can see in the diagram, it is given. Okay, segment AX, AX is the diameter. Okay, therefore angle ABX is also 90 degree. Why? Because angle inscribed in a angle inscribed in semicircle is also what? 90 degree. Therefore, major angle ABX is 90 degree. Now, look at this. AXB, okay, and angle ACB, they both are inscribed in arc AXB. Okay, so therefore, major angle AXB is 1/2 AB. Also, major angle ACB is 1/2 AB. So, from this two, we can say that angle AXB is equal to angle ACB. This is the first proof. Now we have to prove that the two triangles, that is triangle ABX and triangle ADC, similar. So how will you do this? Look at this. From 1 and 2, what we can say? Angle ABX and angle ADC, they are equal, they are congruent. Also from 3 we can say that angle AXB is congruent to angle ACD. So from this we can say that triangle ABX is similar to triangle ADC. By angle-angle test, these two triangles are similar. Now, the next is, when two triangles are similar, we know that their corresponding sides are in proportion. So, therefore, when triangle ABX is similar to triangle ADC, we can say that AB upon AD is equal to AX upon AC. AB is C, as we all know, AD as it is. AX is diameter, which is 2 times radius, AC is B. Okay, now BC is equal to what? AD into 2R cross multiplication. AD is equal to BC upon 2R. Therefore, area of triangle ABC, we all know, it is half of base into height. So base is BC and height is AD. We have got the values for BC and AD. Let us substitute the value of BC as A and AD as BC upon 2R. Now, this 2 into 2, 4 will be there in the denominator. So 1 upon 2 will get cancelled. Okay, so we are left with what? ABC upon 4R, which we are supposed to prove. Thank you for listening to me.